Welcome back to Stegman Coliseum for the final rotation of the evening. This is Jen Sharon from West Virginia, the first time we've seen her here tonight, a 5'3" freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia.
Jen starts off her beam routine with a back handspring layout step out, does a nice job. She actually also trained at Excalibur, where we just saw Marcia Newby. She was from there, and Jen was 9 years old when I left Excalibur.
Has she grown up any?
Just a little bit. She's definitely grown taller, that's for sure.
Head coach Linda Burdett really thinks she has a great skill set on bars and really thinks she can make beam become one of her very, very best events.
She is a great beam worker. I have seen her bar routines in the past. She's very good, and I think that once she matures into the collegiate scene a little bit, she's really going to help the Mountaineers in the next couple of years.
Jen really has a coach who has been around a long time and can teach her quite a bit. Linda Burdett, if you think about this, Corey, the program's been around there at West Virginia 36 years. She's been there 35. Unbelievable.
Jen here finishing her routine with a punch front full off the end and a big stumble.
Back to West Virginia, here's Megan Morris again. One of the leaders on this team.
Definitely coming through tonight for them, putting up big scores. You just saw her with a 9.85 on floor. I should do her flight series. Back tuck to a back handspring. A unique flight series. Wolf jump to a split polpa.
We always talk a lot about seniors, but it really is such a critical role they play on every team. You cannot replace experience, especially come championship time.
And it's also, you become a senior and you feel the weight of the team. You know that you're in that leadership role. For 3 years you just compete and then all of a sudden you're the leader of the team.
And you wonder where the time went.
Exactly. And there's only 16 meets that you have to fill that spot. She ends with a front full. Here we'll see her flight again.
A 9.65. Why the lower score?
I'm not sure if they really gave her a lot of connection for her flight. You saw a little bit of a pause between each of those passes.
From Georgia here, we find Abby Stack, another senior, one of the four, hoping to lead the way to a fifth NCAA title for Georgia. And I really do like her floor routine, her music, all of it.
Abby starts off with a big triple full, and you see here her dance is just fun. She likes to play to the crowd. She has a very unique personality. She's very bubbly, and you just see it come through all the time in her floor routines.
She definitely has a good time. I'm sure the smile helps win a few points from the judges as well.
Second pass, double full to a punch front. She actually has Speed Racer as her floor music this year. Switch leap, Torsha Tejas.
And floor is one of her strengths, there's no question. Last season, she was in the floor lineup in all but one meet. She was the leadoff performer at the SEC Championships and at the NCAA Super Six. Georgia began both of those meets on the floor exercise.
Abby only has one pass left in this floor routine. A big double pike. And a great routine.
I love her ending.
Absolutely exhausted.
I'm tired, I'm done, I'm over it. That was a great event for Abby. And a big score too, a 9.9 for the senior. West Virginia hoping to find a big score here on beam. Here's Shelly Perkett. Her second event of the evening.
Shelly actually has a very unique flight series that we don't see from many gymnasts. It's very difficult. It's coming up right here. She'll do a round off, back handspring, layout step out, and was actually very crooked on her back handspring, but able to pull it back and not get much of a wobble out of that layout. So a good job at correcting that mistake. A beat jump to a split full, and unfortunately there she does have a little bit of a wobble.
Fans are trying to encourage her through her routine.
There she does a switch leap. Most likely was supposed to be a leap series, and there she did an inward turn again. And a gainer full off the side and a stuck landing. Here we'll take a look at her flight again. You'll see right here after the round off, she goes really crooked, but able to pull it back.
A 9.65 for Shelley. Back over to floor, Cassidy McComb.
Cassidy also another gymnast that absolutely loves floor exercise. First pass is a double pike. Absolutely gorgeous.
You can really tell the Gym Dogs put a lot of time into this, and this was one of their goals in 2009, was to be consistent and good on this particular rotation.
There she does a triple turn. You know, in practice, you see the girls out when they're competing, and you see them make their facial expressions and look different ways, and they actually practice it in the gym. All the girls standing on the sidelines, doing the moves with them. There she does a 2.5 twist as her second pass. And you know, when you practice it all the time in the gym, it makes it that much easier to do it in front of the big crowd.
She was a first-team All-American on floor last season and came in 7th on this event at the NCAA individual event finals.
Only one more pass.
Her best score on this event, a 9.925.
Front handspring, front full, front tuck. And another solid routine.
We talked about Georgia's had their moments tonight, but some very good performances both on the uneven bars and on floor. A 9.85 for Cassidy McComb. Wrapping things up for West Virginia tonight, we find Kirsten Sporky. Trying to end this meet on a high note for West Virginia.
Going now for her flight series, handspring, handspring, layout, step out, little balance check. Switch leap, straddle jump, straddle jump. And when I say, you know, each time they go up, I say their leap series or their flight series, they have to get combination in all of their routines as a requirement. Cat leap front aerial with another small wobble.
Again, Kirsten's from Suwannee. It must be so nice to be here tonight. I'm sure she has a lot of friends and family in the stands.
Front full is her dismount. Lands with her chest back a little bit, so unfortunately has to take that step backwards.
A 9.575, not a great way to end the night for West Virginia. When we come back, the final performer of the evening, Courtney Coupette. Don't go away. Welcome back to Stegman Coliseum. Here we find Courtney Coupette wrapping up the evening. Again, a senior from Athens, Georgia. She was injured part of last year. She tore her Achilles against Arkansas on the floor and was out for the remainder of the season.
She actually tore it on this move right here, the double Arabian. And it's one thing that you wonder when she gets ready to go, if that's in her mind. You know, you try not to think about stuff like that, but when you do get injured that badly on a skill, you know, the next time you go to do it in a big arena like this, you just wonder, God, I hope this doesn't happen again.
Yeah, I'm sure it hurt.
Here, second pass. Whip path, Rudy to the Shushanova. One of her signature tumbling passes that she's had every year.
There's no question Courtney's an outstanding gymnast, but also a student as well. You know, we talk about all these accolades throughout the meet, and almost every one of these girls are on the honor roll, you know, sporting 3.5, 4.0 GPAs. It really goes back to the job Suzanne Yocklin has done in 26 years working with this program.
You know, Suzanne says You know, you're here to do gymnastics, but the most important thing is to get your education. And if you're not doing well in the class, you're not coming to practice. So she finishes with a double pike. Great floor routine for Courtney, and I know she is just thrilled to be back helping out this team.
And a huge score for her, a 9.95, a great way for Georgia to end this meet tonight.
So here's the final score in Athens, with Georgia winning 195.425.